Hi everyone, this is Pam, the Arctic Firefly, and today we are going to be making a challenge for the My Pink Stamper. And the challenge is to make a card using the color black, two shades of blue, and two shades of pink. And we are going to be using our Christmas Cheer Cricut cartridge for this card, and I will show you what we are going to be using here in a second. We are using our gypsy, well, my gypsy. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is we are going to create a new project, and we're going to be using a 12 by 12 mat. So we're going to click this little button here, and this will give us our screen that help us pick our cartridge. Click on the cartridge down there, and this actually gives me all my linked cartridges. These are all the cartridges that I currently own that are in my gypsy. And we're going to be using Christmas Cheer, so we are going to find it right there. And on our Christmas Cheer, this is all my base cuts. We are actually going to be using the penguin, and he is right here. Now, the thing about these older cartridges is that they have so many layers, or I should say they have so many cuts, but the problem is that they stick multiple cuts on one image. Here's my booklet. I can give you an example. See, like, they have the base layer penguin right here and his hat at the same time. And then they give you the top layer penguin here, but his feet, his nose, the rim of his hat, and the ball for his hat are all on one cut. So in order to get different colors, you'd have to cut one in black or whatever color you want to make his top part. You would make his feet and his beak in a different color. You know, so you'd have to cut it out twice to get his feet and his beak in a different color. And then a third or a fourth time, depending on whether you wanted the brim of the hat and the ball to each be in a different color. Alright, so we have our penguin here, and we're going to bump him up. So, I actually have my pink. Okay, so this is the way we're looking at it now, but when it's cutting, it's going to cut like this, so I need to remember that. They do have a function on the gypsy where you can create multiple layers. That way, you can do different cuts on one mat. I actually have my paper laid out on my mat here. See, I have my paper laid out on my mat, so I need to coordinate my images on my gypsy with where I have my paper laid out on my mat. Alright, so we'll give this a zoom back in. So we will make our penguin a little bit bigger. I actually think I want him to be 3.5. So 3.5 on there. Okay. And now what I want to do is I want to actually hide stuff. So I want to hide his hat because I don't want that to be cut out as the same color as the penguin body, which is going to be a pink because I want his tummy to be pink. Okay, so we're going to scooch him up and around a little bit. Get him all comfy in there. No. He's supposed to be up here. Sorry. All right. And then we need... Sorry. We're going to want a multiple of him. So we're going to have to... There we go. All right. Created a multiple. And for this one, we are going to want to hide the penguin. And then we are going to unhide the hat, because that's the part that we were going to want to cut. Alright, so now we will move this over here. You see that? I have him over in the hat over in the corner. Maybe I should zoom this out a little bit so I actually see what I'm doing. Okay, now I have the hat in the corner, and the hat is going to cut out at the same as the penguin. Go back to our cartridge here, and we are, get off of that, Okay, now we are going to want to cut the shift of the penguin. So shift penguin, go back to our mat. And we are going to want him at 3.5 also. Alright, and this one is going to be down here because that is going to be our top layer. Alright, and now we are going to go back to our advance. We're going to hide our hat. We're going to hide the ball, hide the beak, hide the feet. Like that, okay? And we're going to scoot him up a little bit. Now we are going to make a duplicate of him. And for this one, we're going to want to hide the entire penguin body. And we are going to want to show the brim and the ball, because those are going to be in a different shade of pink. This guy again, create another duplicate. And we're going to bring this over. Now for this guy, and we are going to want to do the beak and the feet, because those are going to be in the... Alright, I'm going to blow this up a little bit. Okay, we're going to take this beak portion. Well, we're just going to have to scooch it over there. Okay, we had our penguin all cut out, and now he's all put together here. The way I had my mat all laid out with the paper in different corners and everything, using my gypsy, it all worked out just fine, and all the pieces cut out without any problems. So we will just put him to the side. And we are going to be making our own card using Coordinations paper. And I already have it scored, so we're just going to go ahead and finish folding it all the way. And we're going to give it a crease here with our bone folder. With the really thick cardstock, it helps to score it, or else you kind of have these jaggedy, broken... Oh, you can't even see that. I'm sorry. Yeah, you'll have these jaggedy, broken edges along the top, so I scored this first. So there's our card body. This is a standard 4x5.5 card. And because our challenge is 2 shades of blue, 2 shades of pink, and black, we have the black, like we saw on the penguin here, and then the shade of blue in his hat matches the shade of the blue in the card, and I have the 2 shades of pink on the penguin. Here's our black for our mat, so we will go ahead and take our ATG gun. This is our second shade of blue. This is a piece of die cuts with the view pattern paper, and this is our other layer. This is cut 5x3¾. And then we're going to be using this pink textured cardstock. This is also Coordinations. But first, we have this snowflake punch here by EK Success. So we are going to punch some snowflake. There's snowflakes. I have some black grass grain ribbon here that we are going to be using. Using these Scrappy Mom's Winter Wishes. This one says Happy Holidays. And we are actually going to be using a Stampin' Up! Marker today. This is Melon Mambo. We're going to be taking the brush side of this marker. We're going to color in We are going to stamp right there. Happy holidays. Now for our little penguin. Right here, he's been waiting. We'll stick him right there. I'm thinking that needs to be something up here, but I'm not exactly sure what. Alright. And I think we'll put a little bow here. Okay, I decided that I was going to do buttons to fill up that empty space. I don't know if you can hear my husband strumming away in the background on his banjo or not, but... Alright, we're going to use Zots to attach our buttons. You can't really tell, but I have two buttons here that have this, whoops, this metallic thread on them, and then two that have regular embroidery floss on them. So we're going to take our Zots here, take our buttons, put it down on the Zots, pull it up, and stick it down. Stick it, pull it off, plunk it down. And plunk it down. It down, and then we're done. And that is our card for the My Pink Stamper 12 Days of Christmas Day 2 Color Challenge with two shades of blue, black, and two shades of pink. I hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you.